of a 2-0 win for Chelsea over Everton at Stamford Bridge. Manchester City's winning run was brought to an end in the Manchester derby yesterday. Liverpool suffered a sixth straight defeat at home, losing to Fulham. And West Ham are going to continue their push for the top four. They're up against Leeds, that one kicking off at 8 o'clock. So Chelsea, very much a team on the up. They are 4 points ahead of Everton in the table. The Toffees, though, have a game in hand. There you see them in the top four there. Manchester United's win over City puts them 11 points behind the leaders. Leeds going into their game against West Ham in 11th place. And Fulham had a big win over Liverpool yesterday, and they are breathing down the necks of their relegation rivals.
Considering that, you know, this top four race is so tight, how priceless is that victory today?
Well, every victory obviously is a step forward. We know that we had to recover the ground that we lost, and to be fair, tonight was a very good performance. Everton, they were getting very good results. Obviously, we know that they were a tough team, but the team worked perfectly. We played as a team without the ball, and obviously, it's very pleasant to see the team fighting without the ball, and after the quality, I think we could score even more goals.
9 clean sheets in 11 now under Thomas Tuchel. That's coincided with you coming back in the team as well. What is different in this side at the moment? What is behind that defensive solidity? Is it you?
I'm a part of the team that is working very hard, since the striker to the goalkeeper. Everybody is doing the dirty job. And if you see the way we fight for the ball, the way the strikers, they press the ball and allows the defenders to push the line high, obviously it's less dangerous, and I'm very happy with that, because the effort, when you are in the Premier League, you need the effort from everybody. We know how tough it is to replicate it every 3 days. So we are in the right way, but as I said before, we are still far from where we want to be. We are in the right path, but we have to keep working, because we didn't do anything yet.
Today the manager made 5 changes, but you still managed to grind out the result against a very good, as you say, Everton side. What does that sort of healthy competition do for the side, with everyone fighting for their place, keeping their standards high in every single game? It feels as though he can change the lineup, he can change even the system if he wants to, but you all still seem to work together and find that formula to win.
Well, that's a collective mindset. When everybody is working hard, is fighting for the place. When you are playing for Chelsea, it's the top club in the world, and you have to fight for your place. There is nothing easy, and when you step on the pitch, the manager gives you the chance. You have to be at your best, and in every training session, even when you don't play, the day after, the guys, everybody train very hard, and that's why I think when the changes comes in, everybody's ready for it. We have the same idea. We play collectively. Sometimes we adapt to different system. In the same system, different players, which it means there is a different style of play. But the most important thing is that we are thinking in the same way.
Thank you very much.
Tuchel certainly keeping the players on their toes, really using that squad. And let's have a look at how Chelsea took the lead tonight. It was an own goal, but Kai Havertz very much involved in that opening goal.
Yeah, Havertz was involved in everything good tonight. His movement was very good. You see here, Holgate's gone in with Hudson-Odoi. I question whether Holgate should sprint back into position there to allow Alonso in the space. But Havertz, good run. Good contact on the ball that then obviously deflects off Godfrey, but that initially came from Iwobi letting Alonso run off the back of him. Holgate probably not sprinting in to get back into position. Good start for Chelsea. And from then on, to be honest, I think Havertz's movement, Havertz and Werner in those little 10 pockets, they really started to dictate the game, particularly in the second half.
Yeah, they really dominated, and Havertz winning the penalty as well. Faye, for that second goal, Pickford taking him down, a clear penalty.
Yeah, I think so. It's a great ball in by Kovacic. No pressure on the ball, but there he just uses his pace and gets through. And Pickford has to come out, but you see he doesn't get the ball and is almost played for that as well, for the penalty. But then I think we always knew it was going to be a goal when this guy steps up. And I think that's, like you said, his sixth penalty. But yeah, Havertz was it grew into the game, didn't he? In the second half, he started to, you know, come off and get possession deep, but then also spin and link up the play really well.
It's his first start since Tuchel's first game in charge. He really took the opportunity tonight.
Yeah, he had to. We said before the game, we don't know yet what his best position is. Is it number 10? Is it sort of off the wing? Is it as a false nine? But today, you see here, he's getting into those little pockets, linking up with Werner. Just really clever play. Here he's coming in from the wing, running in. Again, when he's out wide, Werner's in the middle. This was clever here because, again, he's just playing in that sort of number 10 role, that false nine role, that give and go. Just clever play for Chelsea, great link-up play. And you saw on the goal as well, he's running behind, playing off the back shoulder. So I think he's given Tuchel a lot to think about. You've got people like Giroud on the bench as well, who've done very well this season. There's a lot of competition up front. Werner today, I think, should have scored. You know, he's got to get in on the goals as well. But a lot of good competition up front for Chelsea, which is healthy.
Yeah, we really haven't seen his full potential. He's had a bit of bad luck on the way as well. Do you think once that's unleashed, it's a really exciting prospect for Chelsea fans?
Yeah, I think so. He showed, you know, he flashes what he can do today. And he's a big player, isn't he? He's come with a big price tag and... I think he's had a good performance. I think just the way they linked up, you saw him all over the areas of the field in those clips, and I think he needed that because I was talking about Frank Lampard was saying that he needed time to really see what he was about, and then he's not had much of an opportunity here, but today he's come on and performed.
And a fifth Premier League clean sheet at home under Tuchel. It's a record in the league. That really gives them a platform, doesn't it?
Well, Aspilicueta said it there. It's a mindset shift. I think Tuchel has come in and, you know, knowing Chelsea, 6 years at Chelsea, I know there's a relentless ruthlessness to wanting to win. And that comes with the defensive side of it. It's not all about the fancy attacking play. It's that defensive side as well. Tuchel's brought that in, you know, to get that record fifth clean sheet in a row is exceptional. And it builds confidence in the team because once you know you're not going to let goals in, then the attacking players can go and play. So it's really, really good mindset shift. We talk about the counter-press as well that Tuchel's brought in. I think Chelsea are flying now. They've got momentum.
Yeah, absolutely. A force to be reckoned with, it seems, under Thomas Tuchel. You can hear from the managers as well on the BT Sport online platforms, but don't...
Everton, Liverpool, Man United, Atletico, and none of them are looking like scoring against us.
And if it looks easy, you know that you arrive in the most difficult. Huh? Then it's the most difficult when everybody thinks it's easy. And I have to give them a lot of credit because you are right. We have a lot of clean sheets, but we have deserved clean sheets. And this is, in the moment, very difficult to create chances against us. And I truly believe that defending is, that football in general is a team effort, a team sport. But defending, you can see if a team is courage, if is brave, if we have a solidarity, if we help each other, if we can rely on each other, if everybody is involved. And you can see all this, and there's a high quality in defending in the moment. There's a lot of intensity, a lot of effort. And that makes us happiest, of course, because it gives us a lot of self-confidence. Absolutely. He was very fluid, very, very good between the lines to have offensive ball controls for us and to accelerate the game for us. We want him absolutely to bring his potential, to use his potential to increase our touches in the box, to have assists, to bring himself into situations where he can assist or where he can finish, to use his body, to use his skills to turn and to accelerate the game, to keep the advantage for us when we open up spaces. And he did all this. It was a strong performance and very, very happy because I absolutely don't. I have no doubts about his talent. I have no doubts about his character. It's Premier League, and he will adapt, and he needs to show the hunger like he did today and like he does in training, and from there on we go.
And can I just finally ask you about your captain? You probably won't know this, but Cesar went 411 Chelsea appearances tonight. He's now in the top 10 all time. You've picked him more than you've picked any other player. The only game he's missed is Barnsley. He wasn't playing so much before. Tell me why he's important to you and how this team sets up and in that position.
I have the maximum respect for him. It's unbelievable what he does. What a pleasure to have, what a gift to have a captain like this. I mean, this is, I,
I believe from my heart in the importance of captains in teams, in big teams. If you have a guy so humble, so full of quality, so ready to give everything for the team with a mentality of a water carrier to help everybody on the pitch, outside of the pitch. So humble, so straightforward, with a smile every day in training, every time ready. This is a gift for every manager, but in my belief, for every team. We have a true captain. He absolutely deserves to have these to have this many games. He's key in what you see, because I truly believe that every team takes the mentality of their top guys, of their captains, and what you see is his well deserved. How do you call it? He deserves the praise for that, and it's excellent.